In this video, I'm going to be going through how you can systematically work out the number of bonding pairs and the number of lone pairs around the central atom in a molecule. And the way I'm going to do this is going through an example. So I've got two examples here. I've got this one and one down here, and I'm going to go through it to explain like how you can work this out, because I could just explain the steps, but I think it'd be more, much more helpful if I just went through using an example. And once you found out the number of bonding pairs and lone pairs, you can then use that information to deduce the shape of the molecule, so the shape of the molecule around that atom. Okay, so in this first question, we've got phosphorus trihydride, and what I need to do is work out the number of bonding pairs and lone pairs around the phosphorus in this particular molecule, since phosphorus is going to be the central atom. Okay, so the first thing I need to do to progress in this question is to find out the number of electrons which are contributed by the central atom. In this case, it's phosphorus, and I can find this out from the periodic table. So if I scroll up, ignore that periodic table. So phosphorus is here, and phosphorus is in group 5, so therefore phosphorus contributes 5 electrons from its phosphorus has 5 electrons in its outer shell. So that tells me the number of electrons present in the outer shell of that particular central atom. So the number of electrons is 5, since it's group 5. The next thing I need to do is work out the number of electrons which are being contributed by the bonded atoms. So here we can see that there's 3 hydrogen atoms bonded, and for now what we can do is assume that each one of these covalently bonded hydrogen atoms which are bonded to the phosphorus contributes one atom. And each one was con did I just say contribute one atom? I meant contribute one electron. And so if each one of these hydrogens was to contribute one electron, the number of electrons would be increased by 3. And so the number of electrons would be 5 plus 3. And after this, what we need to do is take into account the possibility of it being an ion. And this particular example, for this particular example, pH3 is not an ion, it's just like a molecule. Because if it was charged, then if it was positively charged, if this has a positive charge, that would mean that there's probably a dative covalent bond there, and so we would need to take away one from this total. And if it was negatively charged, then it might have been a dative covalent bond in the other direction, and so we would need to add one to this, so the number of electrons. So anyway, now that we know that the number of electrons around the phosphorus in phosphorus trihydride is 5 plus 3, and that is equal to 8. What we need to do now is look at the number of covalent bonds present. And from this formula, we can see that there's going to be, no. Before we do that, actually, what we need to do is find out the number of electron pairs. And the way we do this is simply dividing the 8 by 2. So 8 divided by 2 equals 4. And therefore, there's going to be 4 electron pairs. Electron pairs. Oh, my pen went white. Electron pairs. And so now, using this information, we can first we what we first need to do is look at the formula and figure out the number of the how many we need to figure out how many of these electron pairs are bonding pairs. And from looking at this formula, we can see that there's 3 hydrogens, and each hydrogen is going to form a covalent bond to the phosphorus. And since that happens, there's going to be 3 bonding pairs. And so out of these 4 electron pairs, 3 are going to be bonding pairs. So 3 bonding pairs. And now, since we know that there's 3 bonding pairs and we have 1 electron pair left, therefore we know that there's going to be one lone pair. One lone pair. And this is how we would basically work out how many bonding pairs and lone pairs are present. Now, I'm not going to go into the bonding angles and all of the shapes of molecules in this video. I'm just going to go through the bonding pairs and lone pairs, the deduction thing. So, okay, I've got another example here, and this is carbon tetrachloride. So, C, that says methane. That says methane. All right, what I meant to write here was C. My pen seems to be acting strange. Okay, I think I fixed it. So what we have is CL4. Yeah, that's better. Carbon tetrachloride. So we've got four chlorine atoms. And so the first thing we need to do, as I said up there, is to find out the number of electrons in the outer shell of the central electron, the central atom. In this case, the central atom is going to be carbon. And if we scroll up to the periodic table, we can see carbon is in group four. And so therefore there's going to be four bonding, not bonding. There's going to be four electrons in the outer shell of that coming from that element. So coming from that atom of the element. So what we do now is we know that the number of electrons, and I'm just simplifying it and summarize, like shortening it to E minus, just yeah. And so we know the number of electrons from carbon is equal to four. And now we need to figure out the number of electrons contributed from the chlorine atoms, which are bonded to the carbon. And we know that for covalent bonds, what happens is that the carbon contributes one electron and the chlorine contributes one electron. And we've already taken into consideration once considered we've already taken into consideration the electrons contributed by the carbon. So now what we need to do is to add in the electrons contributed by the chlorine. And in this case, since it's four bonds, it's going to be four electrons, so plus four. And this isn't an ion, so we don't need to do the ionic like additions or subtractions to it. So we just know that the number of electrons is going to be eight electrons. And now, since these pair up, what we need to do is divide that number of eight by two to find out the number of pairs. And so therefore pairs is going to be eight divided by two, which is equal to four. So it's going to be four electron pairs. Now, after finding out the electron pairs, as I said, we now need to find out the number of bonding pairs. And so looking at this, the number of bonding pairs, since there's four chlorines bonded to the carbon, we know that there's going to be four covalent bonds, and therefore there's going to be four bonding pairs. Therefore there's going to be four bonding pairs. And therefore, since there's only four electron pairs and four of them, which is all of them, are bonding pairs, therefore there's going to be no lone pairs. No lone pairs. And so because of so now that now we've done this, we know that there's going to be four bonding pairs and no lone pairs. And in the next video, I'll be going into how we can work out the shapes of molecules from from this information that we've got here. So yeah, I hope you guys found this video helpful, and I'll be seeing you in the next video.